Welcome to Savita lecture cast. Let us see about gingiva. Periodontium refers to the supporting tissues of the teeth. It comprises of two soft tissues, gingiva periodontal ligament, and two hard tissues, alveolar bone and cementum. What is gingiva? Gingiva refers to the part of oral mucosa that covers the alveolar process of the jaws and surrounds the neck of teeth. Clinically, gingiva is divided into three types as free gingiva, attached gingiva and interdental papilla. Free gingiva extends from crest of marginal gingiva to base of sulcus, attached gingiva from base of sulcus to mucogingival junction, and interdental papilla occupies the embrasure space. Clinically, gingiva appears pink in color with firm and resilient consistency. Marginal gingiva is knife-edge shape and interdental papilla pyramidal in shape with uniform scalloping and stippled surface. Histologically, gingiva comprises of epithelium and connective tissue. Epithelium is of three types, oral or outer gingival epithelium, sulcular epithelium and junctional epithelium. Gingival connective tissue comprises of fibers, cells and extracellular matrix. Outer or oral gingival epithelium is keratinized. It is a stratified squamous epithelium. It can be either parakeratinized or orthokeratinized with keratinocytes and non-keratinocytes like Merkel cells, Langerhans cells and melanosomes with tight junctions. It is of four layers, stratum basal, stratum spinosum, stratum granulosum and stratum corneum. On the other hand, sulcular epithelium is non-keratinized due to continuous bombardment of toxins from bacterial plaque. It's of three layers, stratum basal, stratum intermedium and stratum superficial with semi-permeable junctions. Junctional epithelium gives attachment of gingiva to the tooth surface. It is of 4 to 10 layers thick and it tapers from coronal to apical end and it is of permeable junctions. The junctional epithelium is attached to the tooth surface by means of internal basal lamina and to the underlying connective tissue by external basal lamina. How junctional epithelium forms? When the tooth bud forms, it is covered by reduced enamel epithelium. As the tooth erupts, the reduced enamel epithelium fuses with the outer oral epithelium to form the junctional epithelium. What is passive eruption? Passive eruption refers to the exposure of tooth due to apical migration of junctional epithelium. It is of four stages. Stage 1, both the junctional epithelium and sulcus are on enamel. In stage 2, junctional epithelium is partly on enamel and partly on cementum. Stage 3, junctional epithelium is fully on the cementum. And in stage 4, the junctional epithelium and sulcus are fully on the cementum. The gingival connective tissue comprises of 65% of gingival fibers and 5% of cells and 30 to 35% of extracellular matrix with neurovascular bundle. The gingival fibers compose of dentogingival fibers, dentoperiosteal fibers, alveolar gingival, circular and transeptal fibers. Aging of gingiva. There is thinning and decreased keratinization occurs in the epithelium of gingiva with increased permeability to bacterial antigens and decreased resistance to functional trauma. As far as the gingival connective tissue is concerned, as the age progresses, the gingival connective tissue becomes coarser and denser with increased rate of conversion of soluble to insoluble collagen with increased denaturation temperature.